Hi everyone. Today we're going to use a Texas BA2 Plus financial calculator to solve an annuity problem. Let's see the example. Alex has decided to start saving up for vacation in 2 years. He already has $500 saved today. For the first year, he plans on making end-of-month contribution of $100 and then switching to end-of-quarter contribution of $250 in the second year. If the account earns 4% compounded monthly, how much money will Alex have saved in 2 years? So first, let's draw a timeline. We're looking at 2 year time period. So beginning, that's right now, Alex already have $500 saved up. And for the first year, he will make end of month contributions of $100 every month. So for the first year, he will make PMT of $100. So that's every month for 12 months. And end of the year, he will switch to end of quarter contribution of $250. That's for second year. End of quarter payment. So he'll make periodic payment of $250 for the second year. And how much money will Alex have saved in 2 years? So question is, how much money will he have at the end of the 2 years? Because the periodic payment had made change for year one and year two, we have to look at this problem in two parts. So first part, with the present value of $500 and the PMT of $100 monthly for the first year, we'll need to calculate a future value. And this future value will become the present value when we look at the second year. So the present value together with PMT of $250, we will calculate a future value. And that is what we're looking for, how much Alex will have saved in 2 years. Let's look at this question in two steps. Step one, we're looking at the first year. So in order to use financial calculator, we have to identify the following 7 variables. And also because we're looking at the annuity problem, we know all the periodic payments happen at the end of the month. So let's write it here. Our setting will be end. So for all the variables, we already know PV is $500. And the periodic payment is $100. Considering this money as investment, so when Alex put this money into the bank, the money leaving him, when you use calculator, you may enter them as negative. Interest rate is 4% compounded monthly. So 4% compounding monthly, that means compounding period is every month, 12 compounding every year. And the PMT is also a monthly payment, so 12 times payment every year. N is number of years times PY, which give us number of periodic payments. In this case, it's 1 year times 12 is 12. And with all those 6 variables, we will be able to compute future value. And now again, keep in mind that future value will turn into the present value for the second step. Let's write out the second step. Again, we will be working with end mode because the payment is end of quarter. CY, PY, N, IY, PV, PMT, and the future value. So remember, this future value will become our new present value. So we will have that answer. Interest rate is 4. Compounding is still 12. Periodic payment is end of quarter payment. So it's 4 times each year. And payment amount is $250. N is number of years times PY. So we're looking at the second year. So that's just 1 year. 1 year times PY, which is 4, so N is 4. And after we identify this PV from step 1, we can just compute future value. Okay, now we're ready to use the financial calculator to solve the problem. First, turn on the computer by pushing on and off button. Let's make sure the calculator is in the right mode, which is end. If yours is not, you can go to second, BGN, to change it. You just push second, enter. And once you're done, you do second and quit. Make sure you're in the end mode. Now, to put in CY and the PY number, go to second, PY. So PY is 12, enter. Scroll down, CY is also 12 by default. Second and quit. Now for these 5 values, we need to enter 4 of them and then we can compute the last one. So 12 is for N. And the interest rate IY is 4, so 4 IY. PV is 500, so 500, let's make it negative. PV, PMT is 100. Again, we'll make it negative. Compute future value. You'll be 1742.617059. So this future value calculated to be 1742.617059. Notice I did not round it here because it's a middle step. We'll only run it once we calculate our final results. Now, step 2, we'll enter all the information and calculate again. So it stays end mode. I don't need to change it. CY is 12, so second PY. I'll change PY is 4. Enter. Scroll down. CY is 12. Enter. And then second quit. Get out. Now for N is 4, so 4 for N. Interest rate the same. And the PV is this new value, 1742.617059. Now you may change that number to negative because you can consider that money as, again, you invest money into a bank. And if you do use negative, make sure your PMT also entered as negative because, again, that's your constant end of quarter contribution. So let's make PV negative and the PMT also negative. 250 negative PMT. And let's compute for future value. It's 2828.76. Notice now I round it to 2 decimals because we're talking about money. So it only makes sense to be accurate up to cents. Now we have solved the problem. At the end of the 2 years, Alex will have saved $2,828.76. Thank you for watching.